Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm Erin Fehlau. A memorial service is being held at Exeter High School this morning for Brentwood Police Officer Stephen Arkell. Thousands of people are expected to attend. The procession starts at 9:30 this morning at the dragway, the New England Dragway in Epping. It will wind its way down Route 27 for 2 miles, then to Exeter High School. Route 27 will be closed to traffic, but the public is encouraged to line the procession route, and anyone attending the service will be allowed through. The memorial begins at 11, and you can watch the procession, the memorial service, on WMUR-TV as well as right here on WMUR.com. We're learning new details in the case of a Dover City councilor charged with sexual assault and criminal threatening. 23-year-old Michael Whedon is accused of pointing a gun at a young woman's head, threatening to kill her, and then sexually assaulting her a month later. The allegations date back to 2012, when Whedon was serving as both a New Hampshire state rep and a Dover City councilor. Whedon's attorney says his client denies the allegations and intends to plead not guilty. Manchester police are investigating a concerning string of thefts. In the past week, 6 guns have been stolen from unlocked vehicles at different addresses around the Queen City. The first case was reported Friday on Cedar Street. 3 guns were stolen that day. Authorities say thefts from motor vehicles are very troubling when guns are involved.
Certainly, you know, a firearm brings it to a different level. Not only is this item valuable and a costly loss to the victims, but it also is, leads to the potential that these dangerous items can be put into the hands of criminals.
Police say they do not think these vehicles were targeted. Instead, they think thieves are simply rummaging through cars looking for anything valuable. So far, none of the guns have been recovered, and police say this serves as an important reminder to always lock your car and never leave anything of value inside. Well, get ready to pay more at the pumps. For the first time since 1991, the state gas tax is going up by about 4 cents a gallon on July the 1st. The governor signed the bill into law Tuesday at an active construction site for the 93 expansion project. Revenue generated by the gas tax will go toward finishing the project and help pay for improvements to New Hampshire's roads and bridges. And that's it for your morning webcast. We'll have more later on News 9.